Hey guys, Billy here. Today we're going to run through how you're going to set up a GrowWatt hybrid inverter with an auto start or a manual start generator. Manual start. A manual start generator is probably the most common setup. This is where you need to keep an eye on your battery state of charge, and once it's low, you go out and you turn the generator on. Auto start. An auto start generator is a more convenient option that will turn on when the inverter tells it to, essentially when your batteries are low. For this option, you're going to need a generator that's compatible, so one that does have electric start and can be started with a two-wire plug. Manual start settings. For a manual start system, you want the inverter to default to the generator once that is available. For this, you need to set the following settings. Setting 1, you want to change this to utility first. And setting 14, you need to change this to solar and utility. I'll show you how to do that on our most common units. For the 2L units, first we're going to press enter to go into the settings menu, hold it for about 3 seconds. Once we're here, we're actually on setting 1. We want to change this, so press enter to go into that setting. You can use the arrow keys to change this to utility first. That's what it's going to look like. Press enter to confirm it. Now we can head on over to setting 14. Where we're going to set our charging priorities to solar and utility. SNU looks like this. Once you've set that, press enter again, save that setting. Now we've confirmed all of our settings, we can press escape and that'll just take us back to the main menu. We're going to set up the 5kW ES. First thing I'm going to do, hold down enter. We're already at setting 1. This is something we want to change, so we're going to press enter. Now we're in that setting. Use these keys to change to utility first. That's exactly what it looks like here. Press enter to save it. Now we're going to head over to setting 14. Now we're here, press enter again. And we're going to change this to SNU, which is solar and utility. There we go, press enter to save it. And now that we've saved both and 14's flashing, you can press escape to go back to the main menu. Auto start settings. For an auto start system, once the batteries get below a certain point, you want the generator to turn on and the inverter to prioritize that power. Then you want the generator to turn back off again once the batteries are full enough. For this, you need to set the following settings. Setting 1 needs to be set to SBU. Setting 14 needs to be solar and utility. Setting 12 needs to be set to your generator turn on point, and setting 13 needs to be set to your generator turn off point. Both 12 and 13 are going to be measured in voltage if you've got a gel battery system, but for lithium this is going to be measured in percentage. Voltage recommendations. For our gel systems, we recommend setting the generator cut-in voltage to about 48.5 volts on a 48 volt system. For our 24 volt systems, we recommend this be about 24.3 volts. This is about 50% of the depth of discharge. As for your turn off point for the generator, with gel batteries, you want this to be around 57 volts for a 48 volt system and around 28 volts for a 24 volt system. You will have to experiment with this though, because battery age and your charging rate will affect this number. As for lithium batteries, we'd recommend the generator cut-in point to be about 20% and the cutoff point to be about 80 or 90%, but it's really up to preference. There's no experimenting required with this. It's a lot easier because it's in percentages rather than voltages. So with those recommendations in mind, I'll now show you how to input the auto start settings into our most common units, starting with the TL series.
First, hold down enter again, back to the settings menu. This time we're going to change setting 1 to SBU. There we go, enter to confirm it. Now we're going to head over to setting 14. Just double checking that's on SNU still. Now we're going to go back to 12. This is our generator kick-in voltage. We're going to change that to something a little more sensible. Press enter to go between digits. I'm going to set it to 48.5. Enter to save that.
Cool, now we're going to go to 13. This is the generator turning back off again. We're going to increase that a little bit. And set that to 57. Now that we've done all that, and all these are set, just press escape back to the menu. This is auto start settings for a 5 kilowatt ES. First thing we're going to do is hold enter for about 3 seconds to get to the settings menu. For auto start, we want to change setting 1. We're going to set that to SBU. Here we go, press enter to save that. Next, we're going to head over to setting 14. We've already set it to SNU, so we're going to keep it on SNU there. We're going to head back to setting 12. This is the point when the generator is supposed to turn on. Press enter. We're going to change this to something a little more reasonable. Now that's what we want. Press enter again. And we're going to go to setting 13. This is when the generator is supposed to turn off. So we're going to set this to 57. Now that we've set up all those, we can press escape. Charge current settings. Finally, we're going to look at a very important setting for anyone setting up a generator. The maximum utility charging rate. What this is how much power the inverter is going to charge the batteries with from your generator. This is important for a number of reasons. The most important reason for looking into the setting is so that you don't overload your generator or you don't underutilize it. Essentially what I'm getting at is when you're charging your batteries, this setting determines how fast it's going to charge. That amount of power plus whatever power you're using on your appliances at the same time adds together and is all coming out of your generator. If your generator can't handle that, it's going to overload it. Before you can program this setting, what you need to do is calculate your power budget. The limit of this budget is essentially the continuous power rating of your generator. And what we need to do is allocate some of that to battery charging and some of that to your appliances. The appliance part of your power budget is essentially just what you need to run while the batteries are charging. Simply just add all the wattages of these appliances together. Now that you have this number, simply take it away from your generator's continuous power rating. This will give you your budget for your battery charging. Before we can adjust the maximum utility charge current settings, we need to convert this figure to amps. To do this, simply divide the battery charging budget by the nominal battery bank voltage. So for an example, we have 1960 watts available for battery charging. This number is then divided by your nominal bank voltage of 48 volts. The resultant number rounds down to about 40 amps. Now that you have this number, here are a couple things to keep in mind before setting it. Each model of inverter has a different maximum AC charge rate and a different maximum total charging rate. If your power budget for charging exceeds this, then you may be underutilizing your generator. So it is best to check all of this before you buy a generator. On the topic of max charging rates, systems with fewer batteries, usually less than 8, should not always utilize the max AC charging rate. By default, this maximum rate is a bit lower, so if you do need to change it, please talk to us first to see if this is appropriate. Something else to keep in mind is this setting is only applicable to non-lithium systems. Our lithium battery systems control the max charge rates based on how many lithium batteries and what configuration they're in. Finally, if you're looking for the nominal battery bank voltage for your system, it's most likely 48 or 24 volts, but it doesn't hurt to check out the description for a breakdown. Let me show you how to change those settings on the TL. You need to bring up the settings menu by first pressing the enter button for about 3 seconds. Then you need to use the up and down buttons to navigate to setting 11. This is located on the bottom right hand side. Once you get there, press enter to access that setting. Then you can use the up and down keys to start changing the current in amps. Once it's correct, press enter again and this will save the setting. You can now press escape to return to the home screen. And if you've got an ES unit, the screens look a little different, but the settings are all the same. Press enter for about 3 seconds and head over to setting 11. Once you get there, press enter to access that setting. Then you can use the up and down keys to start changing the current in amps. Now we've changed all the digits to what we want. We press enter to confirm it and escape to go back to the menu.
So that's it from me, guys. But if you are earlier in the process and you are in the market for a new generator, please check out the video in the description. It'll help you make sure you get the right one. Other than that, if I haven't answered all your questions in this video, please get in touch. We're always happy to help.